this is what I'm going to read to you today. It's some poems from a collection called Beyond the 9 to 5. Obviously to do with work. So in these days, I'm trying to get information out about the importance of growing food and composting. And I'm up in my allotment, and this one is all about composting. So behind me is my compost heap, covered with blackberries. Yeah, so it's called Leftovers, in praise of the compost heap. Compost maker supreme I am become, hardly for want of it, seeps up on me from practice of digging earth deep and chopping, lopping bits of plants and weeding. None of life's other titles do I hold so dear. My PhD originates in the slimy underground, accompanied by earthworms, caterpillars, maggots, slugs and snails, and slow worms. Instead of whinging at the leftovers of a pinched, screwed up, don't want it, won't eat it, 6-year-old face, I sweep it clean without remorse. A plateful offering to my sacred shrine in the garden. Tree cuttings stake its corner, lined at first with twigs and mown grass, then begin to add the deadhead blooms, sandwich crusts, crunchy eggshells, Sunday papers, loo rolls, slug-eaten outside leaves of cabbage, human-shinned dug-up nettles, comfrey leaves and dandelions. Nourished by me, wind and rain, nature triumphs once again. And this is the actual sculpture that I made in 2008. The picture has since been sold, but it was an amazing thing to do up here, to make a piece of art in an allotment, in a place which is usually quiet and stress-free. And you can grow here. I'm growing lots of things. I'm going to take you on a tour now. Behind me over there you can probably see beans, even primrose. Excellent to use the roots for all sorts of things. And right here I've got my tomatoes. So growing here, tomatoes, some beans I added late, and this sweet corn. And in here you can see lots of mixed beds. Those have strawberries and so on. And over here, very useful comfrey, which adds all sorts of nutrients to the soil. And here you can see me making comfrey feed. And then behind, and here's my cherry tree, which had the most magnificent cherries this year. And had to have a severe crop, of which I do not approve, but allotment rules tell you that no tree can be above 10 feet, which seems crazy in these days, when actually we should be growing as many trees as we can. However, I have an allotment, and the reason I have one is because I do things like that. So on to, here's the sweet corn coming. This should be ready quite soon. Very pleased. Over here, more evening primrose. Got lots of brassicas here. This plant here is a type of courgette. And here are my favourite beans, these beautiful beans, purple beans. You can see them here. You can eat these raw. There's the flower. Amazing. And here I've cleared out some peas, but I'm going to add other things there. And also some tomatoes growing with these, because the beans add nitrogen and the tomatoes love that. So, up here is a cobnut tree. You probably see the nuts growing. They're very beautiful, really beautiful red cobnuts from Kent. So amazing views. And these leaves go very purple also in autumn, so maybe I'll show you that another time. Here I've got all sorts. Marigolds, those are cauliflowers, and these are unusual. These are from Brazil, some seeds that I brought last year from Brazil. Ah, with two little snails. Look, I might have to rehouse these two off my plot and onto my compost heap, as previously mentioned. Anyway, last of all up here, my asparagus and my apple tree. Really good place to be, nice sunny day. Leaving you with views of these beautiful flowers that I got seeds for in France.